Tasks in BuildBook are used to track to-dos that come up in the day-to-day of a job or even to track punch list items toward the end of a job. They're great for managing things that you don't want to slip through the cracks. There are a few ways to create new tasks within BuildBook. One really quick way to do this is directly from your dashboard. When you click the New button in the upper right, you can select the task option. And from here, you can choose where you'd like that task to be created, whether that's within a project or an opportunity, and can move along from there to add your details. You can also directly add tasks within projects. From here, let's say we click on a specific project. Now from the Home tab, you can click New Task, or you can go right to your Tasks tab and click New Task. You can also add tasks if you're working directly in the schedule and want an easy way to be able to get them in here. We're going to go back to the Tasks tab here and go ahead and create this new task. The great thing about tasks in BuildBook is that they can be as detailed or as simple as you'd like. If you need to quickly jot down a punch list item like order windows, all you need to do is type in the title, select a due date, and if you'd like to, you could always put in an assignee as well. For our purposes, we'll just go ahead and put in due date and then hit save. But you can also go in here and add a lot more information. You can assign tasks to a single or person or to multiple people. And then all of these icons below in the bottom left give you the opportunity to add many more details. For instance, if you want, you can add notes, you can add subtasks. There's an option to add tags, which can be a great way to help sort and filter your tasks in your main task list. You can add attachments, whether those are photos or documents. And then there's the option to add scheduling, where you can manage items within your Gantt chart with dependencies. Once a new task is created, collaborators and clients who you've shared the task with can also come in and comment on it once you've saved it, where you can mention each other and collaborate. Another really easy way to share tasks with clients and external users is to click the Share button in the upper right within a task, and then you'll see two options. One is to share with your client. So if you toggle that on, it will automatically show up in your client's dashboard. You can also click this little button that says See what the client sees, and you'll be able to see the actual task. And then from here, you can also opt to share the task with a public link. This is a great way to share a task with somebody who you may not have invited into BuildBook because maybe they aren't as tech savvy or they only have a couple of tasks actually relevant to the project you're working on and you don't really see the need to invite them in. Once we save the task, we'll see some of this information pop up. And then once you've saved the task, you'll be able to see little icons next to them, knowing exactly who you've shared it with. So the house icon indicates that your client can see it. And then this hyperlink icon indicates that anyone on the internet that you do share this link with has access to the item. There are also a few other ways that you can organize your tasks. There are three different filter dropdowns at the top of your task tab. You can choose different people to view who might be assigned to tasks. So if, for instance, I just want to see tasks assigned to me, I can untoggle this Select All button, just select myself, see what I've got here. I can clear that out and choose anything with tags. Right now, I have mostly new tasks and they don't have tags yet, but that's a great way to organize your tasks, whether that is maybe by tasks that are related to inspections or certain priority levels like low, medium, and high priority. You can also sort by due date. This is great if you have a punch list where maybe some items actually don't have a due date and they're showing up here on the bottom. You can hover over a task. This double line icon will appear, which indicates that you can drag and drop these and reorder them. Once you do that, they're now sorted in a custom view, but you can go back and click due date to resort it in order chronologically by start date. And all of your completed tasks, as you check off the complete button, will pop up here at the bottom under complete. And lastly, you can also really easily get these tasks out of BuildBook and export them, whether that's a way you want to share them with clients or post them on a job site, by clicking the three icons to the right of the new task button and clicking print. From here, you have a great selection of options to be able to choose which items you actually want to appear in this report. Maybe you just want to do a printout and put it on a job site for a specific team member or collaborator you know will be available that day, or maybe you want to change it up from that custom sort that you have. Then from here, you can kind of see how that report looks. You can go in and click print, or you can save it as a PDF. And that's a roundup of how you can use tasks within BuildBook.